body to keep the body healthy, energized and invigorated. So we are having so many nadis. So as far as this pranayama is concerned, we have to concentrate on the vital portion of our body, because pranayama boosts up our cardiorespiratory fitness, and this cardiorespiratory fitness provides and energizes the other system of our body. In a strong yoga, and as far as Patanjali yoga, prana progress to the ultimate yoga stage. This means that unless one follows the yam niyam and does the asanas well, one cannot reach this fourth stage. So pranayama is at fourth stage. So first of all, clear the first three stages, yam, niyam and then asana. And after this you come for the pranayama. So in Patanjali, pranayama appears as a fourth stage. This means unless one observes yam, niyam and does not asana well, it cannot reach this fourth stage. So it's very rightly said. So first of all, we'll concentrate on this yam, niyam and asanas, then we'll come at the pranayama. Ask a normal person, what he understands by breathing? Breathe, inhalation, and breathe out, exhalation is breathing. Because in our respiration, inspiration is for 2 seconds, and for as far as this exhalation is concerned, it's for 3 seconds. Means a one breathing is complete in 5 seconds. So a normal person can breathe from 16 to 20 breaths per minute. Means respiratory rate is around 16 to 20. As per yoga, there are more dimensions to the breathing process. In order to fulfill the purpose of the pranayama practice, one needs to understand this dimension. You can see in the picture, in the short video, how our this lungs contract or relax, because as far as mechanism is concerned with respect to this respiratory system, there is a respiratory muscles, that diaphragm muscles, even intercostal muscles, even our thorax cage, it helps for this respiration. Yogic pranayama has 4 sections. First is inhalation, known as pura. Fourth, after inhalation or holding of the inhaled air, known as kumbhak. Exhalation is known as rechak. So both after exhalation or suspension after the air is exhaled and before next inhalation begin, also known as sunakya. So you can see in the short videos how this lady inhale or exhale, how she is doing pranayama. And under this there is a picturization of a short video how our lungs do a function during this pranayama. Thus the breathing process as per yoga can be depicted as below. Inhalation means pura, retention holding means kumbha, exhalation means rachak, and suspension sukanya. So now, after this pranayama, a brief explanation I have given with respect to this pranayama, we'll come to this cardiorespiratory fitness. Cardiorespiratory fitness refers to the capacity of circulatory and respiratory system. means it's a capacity of a heart and lungs to efficiently adjust with the activity, efficiently adjust with the exercise, efficiently adjust with the and coordination with the different systems. Because this supply oxygen to the skeletal muscle. The cells of that skeletal muscles where there is a mitochondria formed. Mitochondria means the powerhouse. ATP means which do a production of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So during the physical activity or in a normal life, we require energy. So this mitochondria produce ATP with the consumption of this oxygen. So there is, in this mitochondria, there is a diffusion process, means gaseous exchange process. During the energy production, the ATP means adenosine triphosphate, it's breakdown into an ADP plus inorganic phosphate. And after this splitting, it provides energy. And after the depletion of this ATP, again there is a resynthesis of ATP inside this mitochondria. So the complete the function with respect to this energy formation, it totally depends on this cardiorespiratory fitness. So we have to boost up this cardiorespiratory fitness. So here I have given one aspect, pranayama. If we'll go to the our physical exercises, we'll go and we'll move towards this endurance type of exercises, which we can say the aerobic type of exercises. The cardiorespiratory fitness, the better cardiorespiratory fitness is associated with lower rates of cardiovascular diseases, coronary heart diseases, and death from all causes. Because we are facing this COVID-19 and the every type of virus, that is corona, which is affect our this cardiorespiratory system. So I think you have seen the so many small videos with respect to measure your cardiorespiratory fitness, you measure your this respiratory rate, the 6-minute test. But as far as your cardiorespiratory fitness is concerned, you can calculate, you can measure this cardiorespiratory fitness with respect to VO2 max, maximum volume of oxygen consumption in 1 minute. VO2 max. When, if you want to measure your VO2 max, so at the time of maximum heart rate, the oxygen consumption in 1 minute is called VO2 max. So how your heart rate become maximum, and what is maximum heart rate? Maximum heart rate means 220 minus age. Whatever your age, you have to deduct that age from 220. 220 minus age, that will come your approx maximum heart rate. So you have to do some exercise, means on a treadmill or by on a bicycle ergometer, you'll do exercise and check your heart rate. So on the monitor, because there are so many technologies, even we are having so many machines, a VO2 max analyzer is there, heart rate monitor is there. So during the exercise, you'll see when your heart rate goes around this 220 minus age, at that time, how much oxygen you consume in 1 minute is called VO2 max. So why this VO2 max? You have to measure your cardiorespiratory fitness. Because VO2 max is related with this aerobic capacity also. Cardiorespiratory fitness is an indication of a person's overall physical health. I already told you, cardiorespiratory fitness tests monitor how well the heart, lungs, muscles perform during moderate or high intensity exercises. And during your daily activity work, you can see how this the blood circulates. You can see the reddish portion is oxygenated blood and the bluish one is deoxygenated blood. In a cardiorespiratory system, the main organs are heart and lungs, and others are the blood vessels. So, I'll explain in 1 or 2 minutes how this blood circulation occurs and how this gaseous exchange process occurs in this cardiorespiratory system. The first, the impure blood means deoxygenated blood comes from the whole body parts via veins towards our heart. And in a heart there are 4 chambers. The upper 2 chambers are known as right auricle and left auricle, and the lower 2 are right ventricle, left ventricle. At the right auricle, the impure blood means deoxygenated blood comes from these veins, and the veins that is called superior or inferior vena cava. And these are 2. Superior vena cava, which circulate blood from our hand and for the upper part of our hand. And as far as the inferior vena cava is concerned, it's circulate the impure blood from the lower part. Lower part means just below from your hand, your arm. So it's provide impure blood to the right auricle when right auricle pumps. The impure blood go down via the tricuspid valve, and the right ventricle pumps the deoxygenated blood towards the lungs via pulmonary artery. And from this lungs, there is a alveoli. I'll explain. And see. These are alveoli in the lungs. Alveoli is a structural and functional unit of this lungs, or you can say the respiratory system, where gaseous exchange processes occur. So, around this alveoli, there are capillaries are there. So, you can see the impure blood, but the deoxygenated blood comes from this pulmonary artery, and there is a partial process, partial pressure occurs with respect to this oxygen, means the environmental oxygen and the oxygen which comes via the circulation of deoxygenated blood from the heart towards the lungs. So in this alveoli, the gaseous exchange process occurs. Alveoli is just like a air sac like structure. So in this alveoli, the diffusion process occurs. Oxygen comes from the environmental through this our respiratory tract, and it's there is a diffusion process inside this alveoli. It releases oxygen and takes carbon dioxide, and during exhalation, that carbon dioxide go out from our body. You can see how this alveoli function. Now, in this COVID-19 disease, the alveoli become destroyed because that virus actually we inhale the air from our nose via nostril, then it comes towards nasopharynx, and then from this nasopharynx it's moved down towards through this trachea, and trachea divided in two parts, that is called bronchus, and the right bronchus and left bronchus. Right bronchus enter in the right lungs, and it divided in so many branches, that is called bronchies, and ultimate the bronchies end with this alveoli, means air sacs, where gas exchange process occur. So this coronavirus, actually in our mucous membrane, whether in our nose, there is a mucus, there is ACE2 enzyme is there, angiotensin. Enzyme is there which contract and attacks that virus, and then its virus enter via this trachea towards our lungs, and in our lungs that bronchus divided in so many types, so many branches, that is bronchies, and bronchies terminate at the alveoli. So when that coronavirus entered in this alveoli, it produces debris. You can say in Hindi, mawad. And it's completely blocked this alveoli where the gas exchange process is stopped. So as far as normal alveoli are concerned, it's after the diffusion process, it's push back the oxygenated blood towards the heart via pulmonary veins at the left portion of our heart, that is called left auricle, and the left auricle contracted, that oxygenated blood comes down via this bicuspid valve, and from this bicuspid valve, it's entered in the left ventricle, and after the pumping of left ventricle, the oxygenated blood circulated towards the whole part of our body. So this is a process, means we can say it's a physiological process of our cardiorespiratory system. So how you have to boost up? So I already told you, by the pranayama or by the aerobic exercises, we can boost up our cardiorespiratory fitness, improve the function of this cardiorespiratory fitness. You can see how this blood vessels circulate blood. You can see the normal alveoli. One thing I want to tell you, in this alveoli there is a partial pressure occurs. Partial pressure means from the environmental oxygen, the partial pressure is pressure H 145 mmHg, and from the deoxygenated blood, the partial process of oxygen is around 40 mmHg. The partial process of environmental air is more with respect to the internal body oxygen. So that's why it push inside the alveoli and the cation exchange process occur. In the same way, with respect to this carbon dioxide, the deoxygenated means the blood with carbon dioxide having a pressure of 45 mmHg. In the environmental air, the pressure of carbon dioxide is around 40 mmHg. So it's low. That's why the internal carbon dioxide push out via this our respiratory tract. So you can see how this system do a function. You can see in this how alveoli and this pulmonary arteries and pulmonary veins do a function. The whitish portion is a bronchiole, means it's a branches, then branches is there. There is a exchange process occur. This bluish portion is a deoxygenated blood. So it's a physiological aspect of this respiratory, or you can say cardiorespiratory. You can see how this partial pressure function here in this, it's the alveolus, means alveoli. This is capillary. Means alveoli is the structure and function unit of our lungs, where the gas exchange process, we can say that diffusion process occurs here. So it's a complete cardiorespiratory system, how it's work. So if our cardiorespiratory system work properly, means it's work in a very sound manner, so definitely we are having a capacity to stop this coronavirus. And see how this, our heart pumps, how blood circulates. Actually, our heart pumps around 70 to 75 in a minute, which is not a normal heart rate. But as far as range is concerned, it's around 60 to 100. If your heart rate go down from the 60, it's called brachycardia, and it's go up from this 100, it's called tachycardia. So these are some physiological aspects. So now the pranayam for better cardiorespiratory fitness, I have explained the pranayam, the cardiorespiratory system. So regular pranayam improves the cardiorespiratory fitness. Cardiorespiratory function is usually controlled by neural, hormonal and temperature mechanism of the body. Any defects on which leads to consequences related to cardiovascular diseases. Pranayams are crucial technique to control these parameters and hence to overcome the life-threatening event of life. So pranayam for better cardiovascular fitness, you can see the pranayam. Actually, here I'll discuss around 4 to 5 pranayam. Number 1 is Bhastrika pranayam. You know how to do this Bhastrika pranayam. We have to inhale the maximum air inside our lungs and then we have to exhale in a normal way. That is called Bhastrika pranayam. So long inhalation long exhalation is there. Or average inhalation or exhalation is 2 to 5 seconds. We'll do this Bhastrika for 10 minutes, and the tidal volume is equivalent to 500 milliliters. So by the proper practice of this Bhastrika, it goes up to 5000 milliliters. This Bhastrika Pranayama. The second one is Kapalbhati Pranayama. So in this Pranayama, you can see the shining on the our forehead portion. So in this Kapalbhati Pranayama, we'll concentrate on the inhalation or exhalation. Most of the diseases are cured by this Kapalbhati Pranayama. The normal duration for this Kapalbhati is 5 to 15 minutes. And for the chronic diseases, you can do for this up to 30 minutes also. But in a very normal manner, because Pranayama, or as far as our yogic sciences are concerned, they can do these pranayama, even the yogic asanas, in a normal way, means without any tension, without any hurry up. So for one time, you can do this Kapalbhati for 15 minutes. So next is our Bahya Pranayama. So whenever you do a Pranayama, you have to come in a Siddhasana, or you can say in a normal asana, mean a Padmasana, or we can say in Hindi Aram Dayak Asana, you put them. So you can do this Pranayama to boost up your cardiorespiratory system. Then Anulom Vilom, and after this Bhramari Pranayama, Ujjayi Pranayama is here, and Murcha Pranayama. So actually there are so many varieties of Pranayama here. So main aspect of my this presentation or even a lecture, yes, you will start your pranayama. It will take one pranayama because it strengthen your cardiorespiratory system, and this system is attached with all other systems. If this system is sound, then other system automatically comes in a sound manner. So I have taken some of the data from this research studies. You can see the Vinayak P. That he found the yoga and Bhramari Pranayama practice can be advocated to improve cardiorespiratory efficiency of patient as well as healthy individuals. These are some references. A study conducted by Karthik and that Bhramari Pranayama improved pulmonary function of 50 medical students. Vantan A. and Kode found significant improvement through practicing Bhramari Pranayama for 2 weeks on 84 subjects. So definitely that Pranayama helps us to strengthen your cardiorespiratory fitness. So from today itself, you'll take oath to every morning